In this short lecture, we'll be discussing past unreal conditionals. Past unreal conditionals are the last type of conditional sentence. They describe past conditions and results that did not happen. Both the condition and result are impossible, not true, or imaginary. In other words, when we write past unreal conditional sentences, we're talking about things that never actually happened. Let's take a look at several examples of past unreal conditional sentences. If she had studied for the test, she would have passed. So in this past unreal conditional sentence, we have the if clause. If she had studied for the test, that's the condition, which is untrue, it's not real. And we have she would have passed. So this is an untrue or unreal result. So if we try to rewrite the sentence to give us the same meaning, we can see that she did not study for the test and she did not pass. In the second example, he would not have gotten sick if he had not eaten the expired food. So again, the past unreal conditional is talking about things that actually did not happen. So if we think about he would not have gotten sick, what actually happened in reality is that he did get sick. And if we think about if he had not eaten the expired food, in reality, he ate the expired food. So we have the sentences, he got sick and he ate the expired food. Let's look at a last example. If she had won the lottery, she would have bought a new house. Again, remember that the condition and the result, this whole sentence never happened. So we can say that she didn't win the lottery and she did not buy a new house. To form the past unreal conditional, we use a past perfect verb in the if clause, and we use would have plus past participle verb in the independent clause. So we can follow this formula. Let's look at an example. If they had studied every day, their grades would have improved. So in the if clause, we use a past perfect verb, and in the independent clause, we use would have plus the past participle form of a verb. In the second example, we have the independent clause first and the if clause at the end of the sentence, but the rule is still the same. He would have bought a new car if he had gotten a raise. We use would have plus the past participle form of the verb, bought, and then in the if clause, we use the past perfect verb, had gotten. When we write past unreal conditionals, we can also use other modals in the independent clause. For example, if she had saved more money, she could have traveled to Asia. So in this case, we're using again in the if clause, past perfect, and in the independent clause, we instead of using would, we use could have traveled. If she had passed her driving test, she might have worked for Uber. So again, in the if clause, we use past perfect, and in the independent clause, we used might have worked. So in this case, we replaced would with might. And again, this whole sentence is talking about something that never happened. So in this first part, she had passed her driving test, so in reality, she did not pass her test, and she might have worked for Uber, so right now, in reality, she doesn't work for Uber. He could have gone to Europe if he had chosen not to work this summer. So again, we could use could have gone to Europe. He could have gone to Europe if he had chosen not to work this summer. So if we think about this, he did not go to Europe and he worked during the summer.